Good morning. We are so excited that y'all are here to worship with us this morning.
There's a place for me. I'm a child of God. Yes, I am.
Good morning, children of God. Thank you for joining us in worship this morning. Whether you're joining us from the comfort of your own home or here at church, we are so thankful that you chose to join us in worship this morning. Let us know that you're worshiping with us by checking in on our website at fccmckinney.org. We really appreciate it. We hope that you can let us know that you're worshiping with us so that we can better connect with you throughout the week. Let us go to God in prayer. Gracious God, let us hear your words this morning. Let us be renewed by your presence. Help us to feel your spirit as we are here in person, ready for you, ready for your wisdom, ready for your words. Amen.
Lost your way, lost your cool, then you straight up lost your mind. Try so hard to stay ahead, but you keep falling behind. Life is gonna pull you down and make it hard to see. But a little change in your point of view could be just what you need. There's always a reason to always choose joy. There's something deeper the world can destroy. Smile when you think you can't smile. Get up and dance, smile. There's a bigger plan, the storm only lasts for a while. So smile. Happiness is wonderful, but it doesn't stick around. Walking on sunshine, then here comes the clouds. You can laugh or you can cry when it falls apart. But I believe the more you laugh, the more you heal your heart. There's always a reason to always choose joy. There's something deeper that the world can destroy. Smile when you think you can't smile. Get up and dance, smile. There's a bigger plan, you got a reason to smile. When you think you can't smile, just clap your hands, smile. There's a bigger plan, you got a reason to smile. There's always a reason to always choose joy. There's something deeper than the world can destroy. Smile when you think you can't smile. Get up and dance, smile. There's a bigger plan. You've got a reason to smile. When you think you can't smile, just clap your hands, smile. There's a bigger plan. You've got a reason to smile.
Lift it up. Atmosphere.
Your glory, God, is what our hearts
it's what we long for, Lord.
To be overcome by your presence, Lord. Overwhelmed with your presence, God.
Thank you.
to be overcome. Holy Spirit, you are welcome, you're welcome here. Holy Spirit, you're welcome.
Amen. All right. Friends, this morning, we are three Sundays in now to looking at what it means for God to be made known in person, not just as some academic exercise out in the distance, but like when God shows up in human form. What does that look like, and how do we experience that? Well, two Sundays ago, we talked about how that was in, obviously, the person of Jesus. Last week, we talked about how that comes to life collectively for all of us in the work and role of the church. We're going to move a little closer to home and look at each of us today, and we're going to do that by looking at the book of 1 Corinthians in the 12th chapter. Now, when we read in 1 Corinthians, this is one of two letters that we get in the Bible that Paul has written to the church in Corinth. Now, it's not the only letters that Paul wrote to the church in Corinth. It's just the first of two that happened to show up in the Bible. 1 Corinthians references previous writing and correspondence that they've had, but this is what we get here in our Bible. And we're going to dig into Paul giving these words of instruction about what it means to be interconnected, what it means to sort of rely on each other, and the varied nature of the gifts that God has planted into each person, and how that brings the church to life. And so we're going to read 1 Corinthians 12. We're going to start at verse 4. Now there are a variety of gifts, but the same Spirit. And there are a variety of services, but the same Lord. There are a variety of activities, but it is the same God who activates all of them in everyone. To each is given a manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. To one is given the Spirit, the utterance of wisdom. To one is given the utterance of knowledge according to the same Spirit. To another, faith by the same Spirit. To another, gifts of healing by that one Spirit. To another, the work of miracles. To another, prophecy. To another, discernment of spirits. To other, various kinds of tongues. To another, interpretation of tongues. All these are activated by one Spirit, which allots to each one individually, just as the Spirit chooses. For just as the body is one and has many members, and all the members of the body, though many, are one body, so it is with Christ. Now, this whole 12th chapter is just a lengthy discussion about varied gifts and the body of Christ and the interconnectedness. And there's all this imagery about body parts, right? About how the eye can't say to the hand and vice versa. And I like to think of this too in more detail that we know now about the human body and anatomy and physiology that Paul just wouldn't have known in that time. And so, you know, the pancreas, which he probably wouldn't have known about, can't say to that goo in your brain that separates your brain from your skull, I don't need you, goo. And then applying the same logic that plays out in Scripture, because if the whole body were just that goo separating the brain from the skull, then who would make bile? It's an important question that we've got to be able to answer, and the way that he poses this is to get us to think about our need for one another, even when we're not like one another. And this whole thing gets defined in one verse. If you happen through all of the 12th chapter of 1 Corinthians, if you were to pick one verse that like tries to get to the heart of what Paul is conveying here, it's 1 Corinthians 12, verse 7. If you take nothing else away from today, take this. 1 Corinthians 12, 7. To each is given a manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. To each is given the manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. It is a gift, right? The Holy Spirit brings these gifts. It is not just a gift that we receive, but importantly, we've got to remember it is a gift that is given by God. To each person, God has given a manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. And to each, then, this manifestation of the Spirit, right, that means there is a purpose within each one of us. And the purpose of the gifts that God is giving us is the common good. That's the goal. If we read into the detail of verse 7 here, to each is given a manifestation of the Spirit. Why? Not for the heck of it, not for fun, not so that I can demonstrate what a fine dancer I am, though I am not. The purpose is for the common good. But you got to do something with it. Right, there's the manifestation of the Spirit. These gifts have been given out. They're planted inside each one of us. But that doesn't really result in anything. That doesn't, just by the virtue of us having received these gifts of the Spirit from God, that doesn't really do anything for the purpose, which is the common good. God's not really made known through us just by our receipt of the gifts of the Spirit. The seed is planted, but we got to do something with it if it's going to bear any fruit, if it's going to like come to do anything of any impact or meaning in the world. If somebody is going to have an in-person experience of God as a result of the gifts planted in us, it means that we have tended those gifts and brought them to fruition. Now, if you fast forward in the Bible, you're going to get to the 5th chapter of the book of Galatians. And that's where we learn about the fruits of the Spirit. If you remember childhood Sunday school, you probably learned about the fruits of the Spirit. My kids learned a song in Sunday school that taught them all of the, I won't sing it for you, but they learned this song, right? And to remember the fruits of the Spirit, love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, gentleness, generosity, gentleness, self-control. This is what the writer in Galatians refers to as the fruits of the Spirit. When the manifestation of the Spirit has grown into something and then sprouted out and come to life and been like visible to other people, been nourishing to other people, been something that somebody else can do with and experience, what does it look like? Well, in Galatians it tells us love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, generosity, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. And so we've got to be asking some sort of fruitful questions about ourselves when we think about the manifestation of God's Spirit in us for the purpose of the common good. What have we done with the gifts of the Spirit that we have received, and what have they brought to life? How have they been nourishing? How have they produced something experiential? How have they been more than something we just receive? How do we tend to this thing that's been planted in us? And it would be really easy for the last 2 Sundays, if you came to those services or watched those services, it would be really easy to think that this in-person version of God thing I've been talking about, to like that we're off the hook. Whew, because okay, first week is Jesus is the in-person representation of God. Well, that I'm not him, neither are you. So, okay, cool. None of us have to really do anything there. That's Jesus' job. And last week we talked about the in-person representation of God being made known through our collective life together as the church. And sort of our shared work and shared experience and our shared calling. It would be really nice then if that's where it ended. But in reality, then it narrows even more for more than that. Just, okay, Jesus, and we get more narrow to the church. And then it narrows down to you and I individually. You and I in the way that we have been gifted by the Spirit of God and how you and I tend those gifts so that they might grow and flourish and bear fruit. This God in person business has very personal implications for us. And for the gifts that we have received and our willingness to tend those, it's not just about the work of the church. It's not just about the story and message of Jesus. But there is a purpose for the common good that God has planted inside of you. There is a purpose for the common good that God has planted inside of each one of you. And to live into that, takes a little work, takes a little tending, takes a little willingness on our part to learn and be shaped even further by the Spirit of God. To each is given a manifestation of the Spirit for the common good, but what it bears, what grows from that is really up to us. If God gave us the capacity to work and to earn a living, regardless of what is on that check at the end of the two-week period, if God gave us the capacity to work and earn, and everything that we earn is only spent on me, that is not bearing the fruit of generosity. If God gives us access to the gospel and the story of Jesus and the powerful message of reconciling love and forgiveness, if we've been gifted that into our lives, but we're willfully and gleefully keeping a grudge and kind of enjoying it, anybody been there? Because you know just how right you are and how wrong they are. That might feel good for a moment. Pastor and theologian Nadia Boltz-Weber says that that kind of self-righteousness feels good for a moment, like wetting your pants feels good for a moment. And then what are you left with? That's not patience or faithfulness. But we've been given the gift of access to the story and power of Jesus. How do we let that come to life in us? If God gave us a quick wit, I'm talking to myself here, by the way, and you use that, the you might not be you, to sarcastically debase people with whom you disagree, that might feel good in a moment. But the use of that quick movement of your brain in that way is neither love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, gentleness, self-control, any of it. The fruits of the Spirit only come about in us when we take seriously God's manifestation in us and understand that that is for the common good and not just for our own receipt, for the common good. Now, people need you. People need you. You may not realize it. You may not recognize it. You may not see yourself as all that important in the lives of people around you, whether they're close to you or by passersby on the street or in the office at work. You may not realize it, but people are in desperate need of you because you are a person in whom God has planted a manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. People need you. People need you and your gifts as an in-person representation of what God is up to in the world. Representing God's love and faithfulness, representing God's mercy and compassion, God's forgiveness brought to life in the person and ministry of Jesus. People need you. So tend to that gift of the Spirit that has been manifested in you, that it might produce something of fruit that can nourish, that can be made known and seen and can be experienced outside of your own life and in connection with the people around you. There is inside of you a manifestation of God's Spirit for the common good in you. People need you. People need the body of Christ, those of us who have given our lives to the way and being of Jesus. People who have been captured by his death and resurrection and invitation to full life. People need us, need you. To each, to you, is given a manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. It is up to us. It is up to us to listen for God and bear the kind of fruit that nourishes somebody else, that takes those gifts and brings them to life. Amen. Friends, each week when we worship, we give an invitation. We give an invitation to know that you belong here in this church, to know that you have the opportunity to connect, to be nourished by God's Spirit in ongoing worship and community with one another. We give the invitation that if you would like to share your faith in Christ for the first time and live that out here with us, please make that known to us. Our goal is to widen the circle of this body. And so if that is you today, we hope that you'll reach out to us in the church office, that you'll give us a call sometime this week or connect with us on our website through the check-in tab. We want to pray with you and celebrate you and welcome you into this community of faith. Friends, we continue our worship as the band leads us in song.
Bring your worry, grief, and pain, every cause you have for shame. Lay it all down, lay it all down. When your cares have buried you, and there's nothing left to do, lay it all down, lay it all down. At the feet oh, Jesus, at the feet of Jesus.
Lay it all down, let's sing that out.
Lay it all down, lay it all down, lay it all down, lay it all down. Lay it all down, lay it all down, lay it all down, lay it all down.
Lay it all down.
Lay it all down, lay it all down, lay it all down, lay it all down. At the feet of
memories we can't erase. Lay it all down, lay it all down. When you come to fear what you can't explain, there's nothing here that can ease the pain. Lay it all down, lay it all down. At the feet of Jesus, at the feet of Jesus.
Lay it all down, let's sing it.
Lay it all down, lay it all down, lay it all down, lay it all down. Lay it all down, lay it all down, lay it all down, lay it all down. Lay it all down, lay it all down, lay it all down, lay it all. At the feet of Jesus. Oh, Jesus. at the feet of Jesus.
When we say the body of Christ, we think of two different things. We think of this passage from this morning where all the children of God and all the many gifts come together to one body. And then we think of this bread, this life-giving body of Christ that we partake in every single week. And when I think about those two things together, I think about the community's experience together. I think about how it's both nurturing the body of Christ and surrounded by the body of Christ. It's dependable. People are there for you. We have it every single week. You are invited in person to come and experience the body of Christ, to come and experience this life-giving bread of life and cup of grace. Let us pray.
Heavenly Father, we come to Thee today with feelings of sincere gratitude and love, grateful for Your unconditional love that You have shown us through Your Son, Jesus Christ. We also come to You today to offer our love for You, for the love of this church, for the love of the people of this church. We also come to You acknowledging that we have fallen short from time to time in demonstrating that same love to the rest of Your children who inhabit this earth. As we partake of these emblems of sacrifice, we ask for Your forgiveness. We ask that You guide us to be better followers of Your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
On the night that Jesus was betrayed, He took the bread, blessed it, and broke it, and gave thanks, and said, "This is My body, broken for you. Do this in remembrance of Me." After supper, in the same way, He took the cup, blessed it, and poured it, and said, "This is the cup of grace. Every time you eat of this bread, you drink of this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death till He comes again." No matter where you are on life's journey, you are invited to come and taste and experience grace.
For you to come, have your way. I am more.
Friends, we're going to call upon the Spirit of God in prayer. I encourage you to take a deep breath and come before God in these moments of quiet with all of whatever it is that you need to say, or whatever it is that you're longing to hear. If you're looking for somebody to be in prayer with you, we encourage you to make your way to fccmckinney.org, click on the prayer tab. You can direct that in a number of ways, and rest assured that there are folks praying for you and with you, either through our prayer chain, with our pastoral staff, or confidentially. Let's pray. God, it has been rugged terrain, and we are tired. And so we bring ourselves before you, longing for a sense that you will strengthen our soul and prepare us for the days ahead. Heal us from the days that have gone by and reconnect us to the nourishment that comes only from you. And so we bring our full selves into your presence. God, there have been moments that have been exciting. Oh, center us in the gifts that you are bringing, in the possibilities that you are bringing forth. God, we give ourselves over your gifts that you have made manifest in each one of us. We listen for your voice and long that we would be diligent in such a way that those gifts would bear fruit, that the world would be nourished through us, that we might be an in-person representation of your very work, of your Spirit and love and reconciliation. God, we long for your forgiveness as it's made known in your Son, Jesus the Christ. Having broken the bread and shared the cup, we admit that we are in need again and again of your saving grace. Use us as those, God, who too are forgiving and extending your grace out into the world. God, we pray for a world that is broken. We pray for those who suffer, who those who are feeling lost and alone and abandoned and orphaned. God, we pray for those who suffer at the hands of injustice and oppression, and we pray that your church would help liberate those who need to know freedom and life in its fullness as you have declared it. put the church to work. God, we come before you and pray the words of your Son, Jesus, in one voice offering them to you. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Friends, we want to give you a word of encouragement to be tied into the life of the church in all of its ways, inside this building, during this time of worship, and beyond. And so you're going to find on the screen and shared with you right now just some of the ways that you can be tied into the church outside of this time of worship. I want to remind you to check in and let us know that you were here. You can do that on fccmckinney.org. Use the check-in if you're visiting, if you're online or in person, if you've been here for 100 years, we don't care. We want to know you were here to celebrate the fact that we were able to worship together. If you're a member of the FCC board, we want to remind you that we're meeting tomorrow night at 7 p.m. That'll be via Zoom, and you should have that link emailed to you, and we look forward to your participation in the leadership of this church. If you're an elder and you are up for in-person worship, please contact the church office or our elder chairman, Alan Knight, so that you can get on the schedule for serving during our worship services. As a reminder, if you go to fccmckinney.org, you can find places to pray, places to check in. You can find our newsletter and other announcements about things that are going on here in the church. So we direct your attention that way for so much of what is going on here at the church and in our Christian community. I want to remind you, if you didn't get the chance on the way in, that on the way out, you can offer your financial gifts, your tithes and offerings to this church. Or if you want to give online, you can give on our website. You can also give through the Give Plus mobile app. You can find that on your phone through your phone's app store, and we encourage you to make use of any of the avenues for giving to this church and funding our shared ministry that work best for you. At 10 o'clock here in just a few minutes, Adult Sunday School is going to meet in person here at the church or on Zoom. The link for that is, you guessed it, at fccmckinney.org. Anybody know that URL yet? We're going to keep saying it. I want to remind you that if you are in the building today and in the next 7 days you start feeling symptoms associated with COVID-19, please contact the church office so that we can do all of the important contact tracing. But we appreciate everybody's safety and adherence to the protocol that we've been using here as we worship in person. Friends, the Spirit of God is moving. The Spirit of God is making manifest inside of you gifts for the common good. It is up to us to listen further for that Spirit, to feel that movement of God, and to dedicate ourselves to that common good, to bring those gifts to fruit, to nourishment for the world around us. People need you. People need you and the gifts that God has put in you and the fruit that will come of them. Look for those places to serve and those places to be of blessing. Go in peace.
Lost your way, lost your cool, then you straight up lost your mind. Try so hard to stay ahead, but you keep falling behind. Keep your faith, make it hard to see. But a little change in your point of view could be just what you need. There's always a reason to always choose joy. There's something deeper the world can destroy. Smile when you think you can't smile. Get up and dance, smile. There's a bigger plan, a storm only lasts for a while. So smile.
Yeah.
Happiness is wonderful, but it doesn't stick around.
Come on,
walking on sunshine, and here comes the clouds. You can laugh or you can cry when it all falls apart. But I believe the more you laugh, the more your heart will heart.
There's always a reason to always choose joy. There's something deeper the world can't destroy.
Smile when you think you can't smile. Get up and dance, smile. There's a bigger plan and you gotta.
plan. You've got a reason to smile. Always a reason to always choose joy. There's something deeper the world can destroy. Smile when you think you can't smile. Get up and dance, smile. There's a bigger plan. You've got a reason to smile. When you think you can't smile, just clap your hands, smile. There's a bigger plan. You got a reason to smile.
Thank y'all so much for tuning in this week. We hope y'all have a blessed week. We'll see y'all again next week.